Wow. Oh man, that is so awesome. I love it. Greetings, guys and girls, fellow gamers. My name is GamesOKX, and welcome back to 7 Days to Die. We had a couple of Girl Scouts here, which are very determined in trying to sell their junk, but we are lucky in being able to keep them away from us. Oh, nice. I love it. Okay, we might take care of this lady here with our club as usual. Oh yeah, she has a bit of a headache. She's not feeling too well. She was telling me she needed the money for medicine. This was not Miriam, by the way. Miriam, I was told, was a gentle soul. She would not have turned into a zombie. So, oh, hello. Oh yes, gotta give you a good smack in the noggin. Now, I want to kill that bear over there, so let's see how that goes. Yeah, I already died earlier as I made my way here because one of the bears bit me in the ass on the way into the house. So I decided, you know what? Somebody was telling me that the blunderbuss slows down people or things. So let's try that out. Let's see how that goes. Hi, bear. Are you gonna slow down? Oh, look at that, you are. Isn't that lovely? Oh, isn't that amazing? That is great. I like that it slows the bear down. So you can go around it. How long does it slow it down for? Oh, wow. Quite a long time. Oh, yes, right in the forehead. That is lovely. I like it. Oh, nice. I love it. This is gonna be my go-to guide for dogs and bears. So seeing that it slows things down to walking speed, this is extremely good for nighttime hunting. If it has a good spread and can hit more than one enemy, then wow, absolutely. This is gonna be awesome. For running zombies, especially. So let's see, let's get some meat. Oh, look at this bastard. Oh yes, so much meat and stuff and things and nice. I love it. Let's get the stone axe. Nice, I like it. Is there still somebody moaning? You dead?
You dead?
Yes, you are. See, don't moan. It's rude to moan. Okay, so let's go back in our house. This is the one where I settled. So if you look here, I basically went all the way around and then I made my way into the middle. And that's where we're gonna stay. So a lot of you were saying there's good luxury houses, there's houses with pools, there's houses probably with. Oh, look at that! I didn't know that. You were telling me about a house that has a flooded basement, which is a great water source, but I absolutely did not realize that this was that house. That is awesome! Aww. I'm gonna scrap that. We have so many feathers. Oh, let's actually get this for bones. Nice. Okay, look at that. Wow. Okay, we're gonna have to check that out. That is awesome. I didn't even know that. Okay, so let's fix up the door. Now, actually, let's not upgrade it because I think I don't want that entry as a door because zombies, somebody was asking about the doors, yeah? Zombies get attracted by doors. So look at that. There's water here. Can we get into the basement? Is there actually stairs into the basement? Huh, no. Okay, I haven't looted this house yet. Oh, okay. This is beautiful. I like this house. Yeah, I don't like doors like in the house. I like to be running around freely. Now, is there actually. Oh, look. Yes, that is amazing. Wow. Oh, man. That is so awesome. I love it. Oh man, that is so cool. There's a door? Oh, this is. Oh man, this is a whole new level of exploration. Can we make like scuba gear equivalent and then just breathe underwater? That would be so cool. Where's the door? Oh, there's a door over there. Does that door go to the outside or is that another. Unlocked. Oh man, this. Oh shit, we have to get out. We have to get out. Shit, I got turned around. Get out. Oh, wow. Okay, so I think the only way of getting the water rid of is by. Done this, maybe? Okay, let's... Oh, that is amazing. Let's see if we can somehow block the water out. No? It doesn't seem to. No. It doesn't seem to want to do that. Okay, so... I'm not sure how we're gonna get the water out there, but... This is another challenge. I think I'm gonna have to think about that. So let's not waste any more time on that. This is awesome. I'm absolutely loving this. This is so cool. So he's like, what are you doing? Put my head in the water for, like, you little bastard. Like, I can't breathe underwater. And he's like, anyway, so we could possibly dig a hole all the way through, I think. And on the wall of it, and then make it all the way go through, because I want to remove... Oh, look at that. There's a hole here. Yeah, we're going to have to do that. We're going to have to dig all the way through, and I'm going to have to make some clothes, because... yeah, let's just do that with wood first. This is... wow, this is broken. Okay, guys, before we go out, I think we're going to go out, regardless if it's day or night. So I'm going to just quickly craft an anvil before we leave, so we can put that here for later. And I'm going to keep this burning... And we're gonna go. We're gonna see what the first building is we're gonna loot. So let's go outside. I know it's nearly... The zombies will start running, but if the blunderbuss is really that awesome, then yeah, hell, why not? Let's see how our food and water is. Yeah, we're doing okay. I have some extra drink with me, a bit of yucca juice. I'm gonna be freezing my nips off pretty much because I have no clothes. But, well, that's a different thing. So let's see what building is close to us here. What is the closest shop? So let's start... I think this one over there is the closest one. Yes! It's either a Shotgun Messiah, I don't really remember. There's a restaurant over there, I think, or a car place, I'm not quite sure. And oh, there's a gas station. Is that the bookstore over there? Because I think the bookstore is what I should want to go in first. No, that's the Working Stiffy. And this is the Shotgun Messiah. Where was the bookstore? I think the bookstore... Is that the bookstore? I think the bookstore was all the way over there on the edge. I think. There we go. Nice. Okay, so let's go over to the bookstore. We might have to spend the night there and looting, but we'll see. There's not a lot of zombies right around here. There's a few in front of the shops. We don't want them to come in later, so let's take care of them now. One there, and the other one here. There we go. Nice. Oh, lovely. Got him right in the face. Nice. Now, like I said, the only reason I take care of them now is because once they start running, they're going to be a big pain in the ass. So the more I can... get rid of now, the better. Okay, here we go, and... Oh, lovely. Oh, hello. Did somebody lock you in? That is so rude. Okay, you're coming out? There you go. Helped. I helped. Oh, you little bitch. How can you dodge something with a blast radius of, like, I don't know, that much? Okay, I think... Oh, I can hear some footsteps. Yep, I knew it. Come on, you. Can't see me. Ah, now he saw me. Oh, yes! Awesome sauce! Nice. Lovely. Okay, so... Let's loot this guy, and I think that's it. If we're lucky. Yeah, everything is quiet. Just be calm before the storm. Okay, let's get into the bookstore. I'm gonna bunker all up in there. And put a chest on the inside. Okay, that's it. So now let's just be very, very quiet. Okay, guys, we locked ourselves in. I got some wood across the forest here and blocked ourselves in. So we nicely barricaded ourselves in. We have a lot of spare wood, so we might actually go over the top with the... Let's see actually how far we can upgrade this. So we get one wood, then two wood. And what is after that? Okay, and then it goes into metal. So that's actually pretty cool. So we could do that. So you can actually get yourself pretty much barricaded in, which is pretty nice. I like it. That's pretty cool. Nice. Okay, I closed all of these. These ones here, I intentionally filled in the bottom block, and I open these two when I run out. And that is basically, if I have zombies coming and hitting this, I can actually remove this block and start hitting them in the face. And at the same time, they can't run in. So I have a way of removing this, hitting them in the face, and this is a bit more solid, so it can't be destroyed that quickly. Well, it will be with the zombies, but we'll see. So let's go and start looting. Oh yeah, I want to put the chests down. This one is actually for scrap. So let's put a chest down here. And yeah, screw the feckin' symmetry, like, or whatever. Like, you know, just put everything in. So we have food, we have... yeah, we can put the spare wood in there as well. Who cares? So let's put it all in there. Nice. Okay, excellent. And then put that in there. And we'll leave the bomb here and this here, just in case we get overrun. Excellent. So let's start. Let's have a look and see what we can find in this. Oh, nice. Starting good. Gonna take the pictures for glass, because I don't have that much sand with me, actually. So let's have a look in here. I also can't make any torches, so the headlight has to do. And it has gotten better. It has gotten much better since the Alpha 14 initial release. Absolutely. So let's start here. Zombies are running now, so we might actually crawl through the place instead, just in case, to not get too much attention and not to make too much noise. I don't know if this is still a thing, that you make less noise opening crates and all that when you're crouched. I don't know, it just doesn't make sense in a way to me anyway. Only because you crouch, it doesn't mean you're quiet. If anything, you're quiet because you open something slowly, not because you crouched. So that never made sense to me, that when you're crouched and you open a chest, that all of a sudden the chest is quieter. It's like, why? If it needs oil, it needs oil. It doesn't matter if you're crouched, stand on your head, or open it with your feet. It doesn't really make a difference. If you know what I mean. So let's take all these pictures with us. You can't destroy these guys, which is a pain in the neck, because you can only pick them up when you destroy them. Okay, so let's pick up that. Let's take the paper for that. There we go, nice. And the basket. And we did get the books here. Yes, we did. So let's just do these books here. Nice. Another glove. I'm not going to read them because I want to loot them first in case we do get overrun, that we have the time to run off without worrying too much. Okay, a lot of paper. We got it. Okay, so what do we have in recipes now? A gas can. Let's see if we already knew that. No, recipe unlocked, gas can, excellent. I will get a lot of times confused between what I learned and what I didn't, because I'm playing the different type of games. I'm playing the modded game, I'm playing the vanilla game. It's, yeah, it can get very confusing. I don't know if I'm gonna make a video on that, but yeah, a lot of people were asking how I play vanilla. Oh, yes, oh, love it, oh my god, this is like orgasmic. Oh, this is awesome. There we go. Mini bike chassis. Oh, shivers down the back. Ooh. And boots. These boots are made for walking, and that is what they'll do. They hit the gas pedal on a mini bike and drive all over you. There we go. Oh, and yeah, they always come to us just like our local buses. They're either 20 minutes late or an hour late, and then they show up all at the same time. One is the early one, and the other one is the earlier one. Did you notice that? I don't know if that's the same in your area. Buses are never late. Ever. Ever. Whenever... I'm taking a bus on the very first stop, okay? Which means the buses stand there, and they wait for their turn. And we have electronic timetables, and the timetable basically counts to zero. And I'm gonna read this while I'm talking to you. It counts to zero. And as it counts, like, it doesn't count to zero, it just says, oh, 2 minutes left, 3 minutes left, and then it goes to, yeah, it counts to zero. And, oh, look at that, an SMG, did I already know that? Yeah, I did. And exploding crossbow balls. Nice. And the timer goes off, and there's like 3 or 4 buses standing at the first stop. So you go to one of the buses and say, dude, like, the time just counted down. It's already like 2 minutes past. Like, you know, you're supposed to leave. What's the story? And they look at you and they go, what do you mean? It's not my turn yet. And it's like, well, there's 4 buses standing. Can you talk to the other bus drivers and figure out whose turn it is? Because one of you is going to have to drive. And it happens to be that, oh, one is not on shift yet. And he just likes to spend time there because balls, who knows? And he likes to be with his other bus driver friends. The other one is not even in his bus. He's like sleeping somewhere in the back of it. And the other one says, oh no, I it's not my turn. I'm not until 20 minutes from now. And it's like, okay, are you all here because you're just having a great time? You know, one of you is going to have to drive. End of story, like, you know. And you're going to start pressurizing them. And they're going to say, okay, I will be going now. Because basically, because you give them shit, and they're gonna eventually go, oh, fine, I'm gonna drive then now. But I'm the early one. There's always an early one. They're always early. They're never late. They always decide to drive early for you. And that really pisses me off. I really wish they would own up to their shit and say, oh, yes, I didn't realize it was that time. Oh, I screwed up. I didn't look at the clock. Like, what is it with them constantly having excuses? I don't understand. The funniest answer I ever got from a bus driver was, I went into the bus and say, you know, you're like, you know, late, like, you know, leaving. And I said, like, you know, what's the story? Every day, like, the bus leaves like random. Like, say it leaves at 6 o'clock, sometimes at 5 past 6, sometimes 10 past 6. And that's at the first stop where the buses are there, the one I was just talking about. And the best excuse I ever heard is like, when I look at when the electronic timetables before they were there, we had apps, you know, which basically feed off the other electronic timetables, which already were there. So there is an electronic system, and the apps tell you when the bus is due. And you tell them, listen, you were due 5 minutes ago. And I checked the website, for example, yeah, or the app or whatever. And the best answer I got from a bus driver was, well, that's just the website. Don't believe what you read on the web. And it's like, sorry, that is your corporate website. It's the website from your bus organization that basically tells us when the buses are due and when they're due, like where they're due. And you're telling me not to believe that. Oh, you know how the internet is. Just don't believe on it. It's like, seriously, some people really have to get a good smack behind the head. But anyway, so I thought that might have been it wasn't actually a rant. I was just telling you because I thought it's something to talk about while we're taking these doors apart and while we're getting into places. But yeah, I find that interesting. It's a fascinating, oh wow, that's a very strong steel pickaxe. It's strong. It's a very fascinating little thing for me, like the whole bus thing that never seems to work. So let's see how fast we're gonna get into the wall safe. Okay, if we crouch, is it quieter? No, because that wouldn't make sense. You still hit it as hard. But wow, it does take it apart really, really quickly. Look at that. Ooh, nice, shiny. Scrap that. Yeah, we're gonna take them boys home. Okay, I think that was already it. That is pretty cool. I like it. That was pretty fast. Yeah, anyway, so yeah, sorry about that little ranty sounding thing. It wasn't meant to be a rant, it was just meant to be a funny story, but that's it. So let's see what we have here. Oh, there's another cabinet. Nice. Didn't even realize there were cabinets. I like that it's close. Makes you feel so much safer. And then you look out here and go, oh, I hope you can't see me. This is magic wood frame. They cannot see you through the... No, they can't see you through the wood frame, but they can literally see you through the wall. Okay, that's it. Nice. I think we've done. We completed this room. Pretty awesome. So let's put everything in here and then see what we're going to take back to the base. And then let's go outside in the dark. This is going to be interesting. Our bed is over here. I think, where's my bed here? I can hear someone growling. I can hear someone howling. Ah, screw it. Let's just walk. I'm just gonna run. Well, how do they know if I'm not a running zombie? They don't know that. They're not experts in zombie behavior. Ooh, did we loot these cars? I probably shouldn't have a wood frame in my hand when I'm outside at night, because it's like, you know, you can't smack a zombie a wood frame across the head and expect it to die. Oh, jeez, I got a fright. That was a deer. Okay, our house is here. And I think we're there. Wow. That was really fast. And I think we survived. Awesome. Ooh. Do we have room? No. Do we have to eat, maybe? Can we eat? Yes. Can we eat more? No. So we scrap that. I'm gonna take the feathers. Nice. So this is our little house. Excellent. Oh, shit. Oh, shit. Shh. Shh. Be very, very quiet. That is our house, isn't it? I think so. No, it isn't. Bastard. We are actually over there, in that house. Oh, shit. Oh, it's a fucking pig. I thought it was a mini bear. Oh. Mini zombie bears are very dangerous. Oh, I can hear the flames of the fire. Flames of the fire? Okay. That was pretty cool. We actually haven't looted this place yet. Oh, nice. Okay, we're gonna get back to you when I emptied my pockets. Oh, sweet. Good drink in there. Nice. And I don't know if this is one of those things where, oh no, this doesn't have a hidden treasure in the floor because there's water underneath. So yeah, this is, I'm really excited about this place because it has the water there and, okay, what do we get from you? Okay, let's empty everything before we take that all apart and go from there. Let's definitely board up the windows because they look actually pretty awesome when they're boarded up. Yeah, that's nice. I feel much safer with that for some reason. I don't know why. I know the zombies hit them, probably break them in one hit, but... There we go. Nice. It's looking good. It's looking good. We're gonna upgrade this one. This is gonna be our little temporary base. I'm gonna clean up all the way around outside that we have no... What are you? Oh, paper. Yeah, I'm not gonna repair this yet because I'm not so sure what I want to do with the floor. If I want to build a ladder all the way from down to bottom, from all the way from the bottom to the top. Nice. Okay, so let's go upstairs and let's empty our bags. Here we go. Nice. Actually, I'm not gonna upgrade these because I'm gonna destroy them. I don't want them really. There we go. Okay. Excellent. So I'm gonna leave this episode here. Thank you very much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this little episode. We're gonna go and loot the houses and the other shops in the next episode. I'm probably gonna do a montage, so it's gonna be a lot quicker. And yeah, if you did enjoy the episode, remember to kick the like button in the balls. And I hope I see you guys in the next episode. Until then, as always, viel Spaß and happy gaming.